Good morning, friends. My name is Vikas Gade and I am a life designer. I read an article on Sunday Times of India, long lockdown taking a heavy toll on marriages. Now, technically, matrimonial lawyers should not be getting so many work calls, but they are very busy these days. With the pressure of being confined indoors, taking its toll on already fraying relationships. Domestic violence is another major reason. There is a lot of stress due to job insecurity and financial uncertainty, especially among small business owners. Since people can't go out of their house, many marital problems such as lack of communication and other underlying issues that had been brushed under the proverbial carpet are now getting magnified as couples are forced to confront them. A lot of Indian marriages survive because people are out at work and socializing separately, but this lockdown has compelled spouses who are not in sync to cohabit in a limited space. A lot of marriages that were on the brink of breakup will also find it difficult to survive the lockdown. Now, I had written a blog in the past that was Marriage Dilemma, Why Marriages Don't Last. I had also recorded a podcast. I hope you have heard about that. It was Marriage Dilemma of the Rich. Now, what is the marriage dilemma? If you ask anyone why marriages fail, people simply say due to ego or non-adjustment. But in my opinion, marriages fail because of unconditioned mind. Whether it's an arranged or love marriage, the chief deciding factor for a girl is possession of a man, covered under various pretexts. The family system convinces a girl to marry this guy and you have secured your future lifestyle. The prime reason for conflicts, extramarital affairs and divorces later. But only 1% of girls ever go for a guy who is middle class or poor, no matter how much time they have spent together. Now, middle class and poor is as per their status. It depends on which strata of society you belong. Now, in India, a rich family means khandani, izzatdar, badelu. It has got hardly anything to do with the man's qualities, only richness of family. So now, if there is a rich family, people will not raise issues about religion or caste as much as they would if is a equal. It's happening between equal strata of society. So the dilemma is on account of wrong beliefs and traditions instilled since childhood, and also girls' instinct that I deserve a man who can afford me this and that. No, so it works for a while and then fizzles out. Both arranged and love marriages equally. Now, what's the result? Today, we see divorces even in traditional conservative families. In fact, divorce has gained more acceptance than a girl's own choice to marry across religions. What do we all seek? What do we all seek? All of us seek peace and harmony. We all want to be happy, but are we? Or how often we are happy? I see a lot of people being worried all the time, and then there are some who are always in happy state of mind. That's what happiness is. Happiness is a state of mind. You face an unfavorable situation. What are these unfavorable situations? You've been denied a holiday, you've been denied a promotion, you are given extra work, even small. So in the article mentioned, as I mentioned on Sunday, it's divorce lawyer who says even small issues such as switching of the air conditioner are raising temperature in some marriages. What do you get from that? What you do? React in an instant. Those sense the no, the temperature soaring. Now there are two possibilities: either you are denied something or you are given something you don't want. What is the underlying element here? Expectation. Everyone wants a world-class treatment and world-class product or service. Absolutely fine. Yeah. Having said that, it also demands you to be world-class first, which no one pays attention to. Now, high class in your attitude and behavior. That's what you need to be in order to command the treatment, a world-class treatment. For example, we all love the Tatas. Why? There is a world of difference between their hospitality and that of others. The Tata culture is imbibed in their employees from day one. What's happening, in fact, is the Tatas treat you well beyond your expectations, and you too are ready to shell out more at a Tata Enterprise, a Starbucks, or Taj Lands End. This is the basic foundation for anything. Instead of high expectations from others, you set out the standards first. Be outgoing. not outgoing in your nature, and more so in marriages. People will match up, they do, or they will leave your arena if they do, are not able to, you know, sustain your standards, and you will be left with people with high standards, and quality and thought of your life will skyrocket enormously. The thing which really matters at the end of life is contentment and peace. Sadly, these things cannot be bought. Thank you so much. Signing off, Vikas Gade.